We are diving deep into the powerful new slicer called Orca Slicer, from installation to exploring its unique features. Also, if you own a Creality K1 printer, then this software is an upgrade for you. We already have Creality Print Slicer for the K1 series, but it lacks a lot of features for now. That's where the Orca Slicer comes in. Not only it is open source and free to use, but also have advanced features and a wide range of printer support. So let's dive into it. What is an Orca Slicer? Think of an Orca Slicer as a supercharged evolution of a Bamboo Lab Slicer and a Purusha Slicer. It takes the already impressive foundation and adds even more functionalities. One of its highlights is a multi-material unit support, allowing you to unleash the power of a multi-material printing on a compatible setups. Install and setup. Head over to the Orca Slicer website and download the version compatible with your operating system. Installation is straightforward. Just follow the on-screen instructions. The beauty of Orca Slicer is its printer flexibility. It supports the Purusha, Bamboo Lab or other brand. Also, it supports Clipper and Marlin. This makes it a versatile choice for any 3D printing setup. I'm selecting a Creality K1. If you have a Bamboo Lab printer, then select this tab to install the plugin. Click on a new project. Interface. Interface is really neat and clean if you compare it to the Purusha or Cura slicer. Before we go further, let's make it all dark. They have bought all the settings in one place. We can add new printers from here. Also, we can connect to our printers through LAN network. Here are the settings for filament to adjust the temperatures and others. Let's import a model first. Here are our normal features to add model, move, rotate, perform cut and other. But here we have now a special feature to add a multiple build plates. We can work on a different models on a separate plates. We can individually slice plates or slice all at once, which is really good feature for saving your time. Support painting feature same as a Purusha slicer with some more painting option. Now we have a handy fill option. Don't need to manually paint the whole surface one by one. Just click on a specific area and go to the normal manual support and we are good to go. But Orca slicer doesn't stop here. Explore the feature like seam painting, text embossing and measurements, all designed to enhance your slicing experience. Want to fine-tune your specific area of your model? Orca slicer's add modifier feature is your best friend. Right-click on the model and let's add a cube. From the object tab, select it. Adjust the size. Now here we can add walls, change infill percentage and other settings for the specific area. This feature is a very useful addition. In this process tab, we can see the objects. Here are the files that we have imported into the software. In the global tab, you will find our main settings for quality, strength, speed, support and more. The best part, you can see your model in the real time while adjusting these settings. Built-in calibration test. Fine-tuning your printer is crucial for optimal results. Orca Slicer comes with a built-in calibration test for temperature, flow rate, retraction and many more. Just click on a calibration, select one test and it will ready to print and test your printer. These features help us a lot for tuning up our printers. We can also save our projects and access them from the home tab. Adding Creality K1. To connect the Creality K1, click on this Wi-Fi symbol. Turn on the Creality K1 and find the IP address. Or open a Creality slicer, click on the device tab and you will find the IP address here. Just copy that. Come back to the Orca slicer and paste the IP address here. Click on the test and close this error. Close the tab and go to the device tab. You can see the printer is connected to our slicer. I have uploaded this balloon car model for printing and sliced it. While direct printing from the slicer isn't possible yet, slice your model and save the G-code file. Then head to the device tab, import a G-code and start printing. Now you're ready to experience the power and flexibility of an Orca slicer. Remember, Orca slicer is still under development, but it offers a promising future for 3D printing enthusiasts like us. So dive in, experiment and share your experience with Orca slicer community. If you like this slicer, consider supporting the creator. If you have questions and suggestions, then comment down. Happy printing.